All right, hello everyone, and welcome to the Spring 2023 CSUN Invitational. First matchup today here between CSUN and Occidental, about to get underway. CSUN roster for today, number one, Mikhail English. Number two, Victor Balderas. Number three, Jaden Randolph. Number five, Isaiah Taylor. Number six, Jamie Chacon. Number seven, Jason Maturi. Number eight, Brian Marakin. Number 10, Sean Nelson. And number 11, Nahida Ogogo. In Occidental, wearing black, Marcus Lee, number 12. Kyle Dosa, number 22. Kevin LaFrance, 0. Anthony Hollerick, 16. Jacob Adler, 10. Nolan McCarthy, 35. And Chase Pagan, 31. Perfect time to have a little playoff invitational while NBA playoffs are underway. Game 3 of Lakers versus Warriors will be tonight at 5:30, I believe. The fiercest rivalry in the Western Conference. Real quick, Occidental gets the ball. The gentleman numbers supposed to be wearing number 31. He doesn't have a uniform on. That should be Chase Pagan. Isaiah passing back to 12. We didn't get a number. We didn't get a name for him. Turnover quickly approaching the basket. Passing it back away, there's Jacob Adler across to number 31, who almost went out, saved it, thought he stepped out of bounds. 12 able to get the rebound. Jaden Randolph taking his time, trying to get himself past Kyle Dosa. And another turnover. And they'll shoot. Isaiah Taylor looks to block, and it is 6-0. And underway on the other court, UC Riverside versus Cal Poly. And CSUN gets on the board. A two-pointer from Jason Maturi. Shot from the corner off the rim. It goes out of bounds on Occidental. Twelve moving up, getting to the paint, shoots, and off target to the left of the rim. That'll draw a penalty. First free throw attempt of the day. Going to be by Jason Maturi. And he's 2 for 2. Timeout called. Very curious to see if Chase Pagan is going to be given his jersey. Scorekeepers will have a hard time. Pagan shoots off the rim. Anthony Hollerick able to get the rebound, put up two more. Zay Taylor could shoot here, and he does. It goes up, puts the makes the first three-pointer for CSUN today. Hey! Ulrich takes his first trip to the free throw line. He goes 1-for-2 on free throws. That's the first one missed, but he gets the rebound anyway and shoots, and that's an air ball. Maddors will take over. Twelve been tightly covered by Pagan all game, but he's able to move up and shoot for two in the paint with these. Going up to get the rebound. 12 snatches it out of the air. Jaden Randolph moves up, passes it across to Jason Muturi, who puts it up for three. Pingleton's take the shot right near the three-throw line. Randolph with the rebound. That one slapped out of bounds. That goes off Pagan's hand last. Occidental so far playing tighter defense, especially around right at the three-point line. CSUN's been having to shoot from outside it more often than not. Goes to look back for himself, but Pagan goes up for three. Nothing but net. And we are tied at 12 apiece. That goes off on the shin of Maturi, the Occidental's ball. Pagan might shoot for the same spot again. Moving over a little bit. Trying to get around 12, and he stays in bounds. Marcus Lee puts it up for three. Zaya Taylor covered by aforementioned Lee. Get it out to 12. Bounces off the rim a couple times and quickly scooped up Jacob Adler. Pagan will shoot. It's another three. Zaya Taylor tightly covered. Ball's nearly swatted as it leaves his hand. Jason Maturi got the rebound, couldn't get in either. Hollerick, tightly covered by Brian Moroccan. Adler passing it to Lee, who puts it up. And Jaden Randolph will get the rebound. 12 will just shoot after a quick pass. 7 gets the rebound. That's Maturi, easier to say the number sometimes. The action is picking up the pace here. That one off the rim. Headed for Isaiah Taylor, but tipped first by Hollerick. Adler will shoot. Goes in for three. Occidental slowly pulling away. Timeout called, 12:05 remaining in the first half. There's no shot clock available. I guess someone will count down from the sideline, blow the whistle if there's a violation. Very interesting how they operate the scoreboards here. They have a little remote, almost like those things you buy stuff at stadiums with now that you can slide your card into, because most are cashless venues. That's what kind of how it operates. Very unique. All right, play is going to resume now. Kyle English will take it out. He's taking his time trying to get a read on defense. Kyle English just put it up. A little alley-oop for two. Chase Pagan decides to move up, and the ball goes off his ankle. That's going to be a turnover, and that's a little overshot for – oh, mistake. Kyle, it was a little bit too in front of Kyle Inglis. Now one will go out. Missed opportunity there by CSUN. Pagan will get another shot right here. Was not tightly covered before moving in to the paint. A little bit of a scoreboard delay. Conn will shoot it again. Jukes Mikhail English off the front of the rim, and it's going to go out on CSUN. Oh, but Isaiah Taylor, what a move. It manages to keep it in play before it hits the ground. Excellent effort. Pagan's trying to stay perfect for three throws, and he does. Less than half of the first half remaining, 8:59. Point ball game here. Occidental leads CSUN 28-16. Kyle English shoots, gets three with ease. Okay, so there's been a little bit of a changeup. Number 31 is not Chase Pagan. Excuse me, he is Chase Pagan, but he's not the gentleman in the red shorts. They made a last-second change when I was down there pregame, so I do not know what that gentleman's name is in there without a jersey. Kyle English is able to turn over, but Jaden Randolph quickly scoops it up. Sinks three for the Matadors. Sometimes the difficulty of club sports is not fixed. There's no fixed rosters. Jersey numbers are fluid at the last second. So apologies. It wasn't brought to my attention until now. That was tipped. An air ball was shot up by Nolan McCarthy. That was Mikhail English, nearly trips going up. Hallerick, oh, a nice point deflection. Steve's able to recover by Occidental. And red shorts put it up and puts in for two. After bouncing off the rim a few times. Moroccan rushing up in the paint and gets able to get two. Edwards looking to make a comeback and nice no-look pass out on the corner to Jacob Adler. Jacob Adler. Remember, red shorts does it again. Puts up Nolan McCarthy, able to get two. Jacob Adler will shoot out from the corner, sinks a three. Kyle English looks a little frustrated as that rolled around the rim and out. Kyle Dosa will quickly shoot. Easy rebound for Jamie Chacon. He's been put in the game. Isaiah Taylor will be out for a bit. And timeout called. All right, play will resume here. Occidental player with no jersey. Adler looking for an opening, just passes it back to him. ...44-28, Occidental. Houston's gonna try to shrink their lead. Perhaps even eliminated before halftime. We've got 4 minutes to go. Adler puts it up again. Alley-oop for two more. Brian Moroccan shoots three times. Not able to get it in. And then... The shot by Victor Balder is deflected out in the corner. Brian Moroccan might get another shot. Pass will get deflected, almost turned over. And that's an air ball. That didn't go anywhere near the net. As they're moving up, red shorts will shoot. Off the rim, but here's Chase Pagan. As it's Nolan McCarthy who puts it up for two, and it does not go in. Oh, quickly. And it does go out. Another effort there by red shorts to keep it in, but that better off leaving it untouched. That would have been on CSUN. They would have the ball back again. Chase Pagan shoots it up. Off the backboard just a couple times today. That one taken away by red shorts. Well, Aliyah put it up for two more, and there's an 18-point lead by Occidental. Their largest of the day with about 2 minutes and 10 seconds remaining in the first half. CSUN calls a timeout. 1:57 remaining. Kyle English puts up the first point since the timeout. Might be the last one of the first half. Both teams fighting for the rebound. It's still up for grabs. Nolan McCarthy gets it. Gets deflected. Matadors take over. Kyle English trying to... he let go of the ball. It looked like he gave it right to him. That was a big mistake, and that one goes out of bounds and off the head of a spectator on the other side, and they were not expecting that. Occidental's ball. No one in sight to get the rebound for Occidental. Less than a minute left in the first half. There's one more timeout called by CSUN. Even though they're down 13, Matador's a little bit better at shooting threes because Occidental's playing defense within the two-point area. And I think you'll see more of that as the game goes on, them taking their time. buying time outside the three-point line. The second to last possession. Just taking his time, wants to drain the clock, so they have no time to shoot before half. Sean Nelson will take it and put it up for two, and trying to get in before the clock runs out, and they will not. And the score at half is Occidental 51, CSUN 35. We'll take a quick break and be back for more action. All right, we are back for second half action here, CSUN versus Occidental. So some clarification. The gentleman playing the red shorts for Occidental is Kevin LaFrance. They gave me the number zero pregame, so I was looking for zero, but there was none visible. So Kevin LaFrance, who I was referring to as Chase Pagan early on. So there's a clarification. Sonny Hollerick puts it up for two. Now CSUN will be able to score closer to us in the second half, based on the court switch. Sean Nelson puts it up. Oh, and turnover and big mistake. Kyle Dosa not able to put up the first time, but gets in the second time, and Both teams slow to get over to that side of the court. Timeout, Occidental. Kyle English sinks a three. Matador's largest deficit has been 23 today as they just eliminated. Might go back up to that right now, and it does. 61-38 is the score. Jaden Randolph might go for it now. Instead, Sean Nelson looking for an opening. Gets it, Jason Maturi, who finds it. Puts up another three. This is what I was talking about earlier. Matadors, because it's harder to score within the three-point line. Because that's where Occidental's playing their toughest defense. They have space and time to shoot outside, like right there. That one, a little off target. I could see that that trajectory was off, was not going to go in. A turnover, a break for CSUN, but they're a little slow getting the ball into Occidental's side of the court. Another turnover again, and oh, it looks like he may have jammed his finger when trying to catch the ball. Something happened to Sean Nelson. He's limping a little bit, that left, favoring his left leg. He'll be out of the game for a bit. Athletic trainers will take a look at him. And we have a resumption of play right now. Devin LaFrance moving up. Trying to get around Isaiah Taylor. Does, but he puts it up and no good. Cardoso able to get the rebound, gets it to Hollerick, and it'll go out on him. Vandors take over. Clock is ticking here, 16:44 remaining in the game. Kyle English puts up with just his left hand, unable to get the rebound. Kevin LaFrance almost turned it over. Isaiah Taylor quickly getting the rebound as Kevin LaFrance moved up. Swats it away back to his teammate for the deflection. That was a good move by Adler. Another turnover. Mikhail English will put it up. Try to dunk. Doesn't have the height, but he gets it in for two anyway. And a timeout is called. And those viewers who are watching while signed in, leave a comment or a message in the live chat. Who are your picks to advance to the conference finals in the NBA this year? Taylor tightly covering Kevin LaFrance. Anthony Hollerick will just give it over to Kyle Dosa. France maybe thought about shooting, looking for an open team. Isaiah Taylor's tightly covering him. Doing a good job of avoiding fouling. Off the rim and right into the hands of Brian Moroccan. Almost losing possession there is Jaden Randolph. Brian Moroccan in the paint, it gets swatted away, and that's going to get a draw foul on Chase Pagan. Ball's tipped up. Anthony Hollerick moving up for it. Chase Pagan puts up for two. 63-43 Occidental. They did not change the period on the electronic scoreboard. Oh, and it tipped, deflected, excellent point guard, but unfortunately Chase Pagan able to get back in. Kyle Inglis waiting for a teammate to get open. Take his chances, might move up, might shoot from outside the 3-point line. Standing back, going for it, and does not go in. Now it doesn't get into LaFrance. Too wide open. Zay Taylor moving up, trying to go for two, and it's swatted, and it goes out. Look frustrated because he touched it last. The ball just swatted out of his grip. But his hand was the last to touch it. Kyle Inglis, mistake there, turned it over, lost control. Official is signaling for a foul there, but play did not stop. Goes up again, Jaden Randolph. They'll get nothing. Clock continues to tick down, 12:49 remaining in the game. Zay Taylor puts it up. A little to the right of the net. Chase Pagan, get over to Hollerick. Hollerick will take two free throws. Score of UC Riverside versus Cal Poly, 46-43. UC Riverside leads, excuse me, Cal Poly leads. Zay Taylor puts up for two, bounces in. Kevin LaFrance weighing his chances here. Going to go for three, moving up. LaFrance buying time out in the open. Puts it up for three. Occidental's reached 70 points. It's the most today so far by 20. McCarthy with nice defense. Deflected it as it was going in, but then turnover committed by Kevin LaFrance. Number 12. 12 passing. Jason Maturi puts up two. Isaiah Taylor sinks a three, and timeout is called by CSUN. Looked like his foot was didn't look like his foot was touching 3-point line, but they only give him two for that. Play resumes here, 9:38 remaining. Matadors have to do something quick if they want to win this game. Chase Pagan puts it up. Nolan McCarthy with that height, able to get the rebound. Pagan will get another shot here. No, it... Oh. And kicked accidentally by CSUN. That was number one, Mikhail English. Looked to have a good takeaway, but didn't go as planned. And Marcus Lee, back in the game, puts it up for three. Kindler stepping back. That's a Sean Nelson. Get it to Victor Balderas. Waiting for an opening to shoot for three, and they're playing tight coverage. That's an air ball by Jason Maturi. Turnover, committed by Mikhail English. Hung his head low as he went to the other side of the court. Lee will put it up, and it goes out of bounds on CSUN. But Jaden Randolph was attempting to get the rebound. missed coverage, but does not go in. Number 12, that looked like it was his guy. But able to get the rebound. Looking like who's supposed to cover him? I can't cover both of them. There was a miscommunication there on defense by CSUN. He sinks a three. Kyle English's shot goes kind of the opposite direction. But as he was going underneath in it, he had to kind of pass it up but behind him instead of in front of him. Both put up for CSUN, another three-pointer for him. Second in a row. Marcus Lee puts it up. Able to get in. Jaden Randolph quickly got the rebound. Moving up. Him and Jason Maturi gets two, and Gene Randolph will get the assist. Kyle Dosa will go for it all. Shoots for three. Looked like it was going in. Just bounce off the rim. That always get the easy rebound. Kyle English puts it up. It was tipped out of bounds. The Matador's ball. Everyone tightly covered. Had to pass it all the way like down half the court to number 12. Isaiah Taylor. Covered by Nolan McCarthy. The jumps, tries to get a deflection. Nice juke to buy himself some time. 12 moves up. Jaden Randolph put up for three and rolls out. Nolan McCarthy will take the pass and put up a quick three-pointer. It's 82-62 Occidental, and they've got this game just about wrapped up with 3 minutes and 9 seconds remaining. 12 scoops up the rebound, one hand. Moving out, might take the shot for himself, moves up, shoots for two, able to get it in. Adler moves up for two, gets the, try to get the alley-oop. Gets the assist, but Kyle Dosa will get the 2 points. Randolph puts up for two, tries to get it in. Nolan McCarthy tries to pass it behind him, nearly gets turned over. Kyle Dosa. Gets fouled by CSUN number 12. Occidental pull out to an early lead in this game. If you remember, they were up 6-0. So they set the tone early, and CSUN could not catch up. They came to play here in this tournament. They have 84 points. That's 14 more than the team with the second most over on the second court, whose game just ended. Time ticks down. Matadors will wait to see who they play in the second game. Final score, Occidental 84, CSUN 66. That's it for this first stream. We'll see you soon for the next matchup.